Hey everyone, welcome back. Today I've combined seven of the best new UX UI portfolio resources, courses, checklists, examples, and portfolio reviews to create the best job-worthy or work-worthy UX portfolios. All of these are free, of course, and some of them are from the best companies in the world. So let's check them out. All right, so the first resource is actually a guide from the designers at Spotify. Yes, they actually sat down and an interviewer asked them particular questions related to portfolio designing and how to curate your own portfolios. This is a very lengthy read, but it covers every aspect of portfolio design. How do you decide what project to do for your portfolios? What is the ideal or the best portfolio structure? How to design the portfolio one by one? What is the first, second, third? What is the kind of order that you should place elements in your portfolio for the best results? And different designers have given different perspectives, all Spotify designers, but different perspectives on the same pointer as well. So you'll get the best of all these designers' perspectives. There are also some do's and don'ts of how not to mess up your portfolio or what to avoid. They also go through how to submit the portfolio properly. A lot of people might just send their portfolio link, but is it the best option to do that? That is something that they've covered in their extended guide as well. The next resource is something that I have created for you guys. So Dann Petty is someone who I have followed for many years. Even before I started as a professional, I used to follow his work. He is one of the best in the web design game, at least. And he's given some amazing gems, some gold bars to you guys through a bunch of his UX portfolio reviews on Twitter and even on his YouTube and stuff like that. I have gathered all the different portfolio reviews he's done. I have marked them. I have given the titles, so you know exactly what you're getting into, because he doesn't really give titles. He just describes his videos essentially. So I've done like proper title work for the videos as well. And I've given each link that is there publicly for his reviews. Some of these reviews are 1 hour, 1.5 hours long. Some of these videos are literally 10 minutes long, giving you more tips and tricks. Some are more focused on one point, some are focused on job-ready portfolios, and some are even focused on just fun stuff, some creative stuff. That's it. So you'll know exactly what to do at the end of this. It's like a one-pager, and I have a full page of links here. Go check this out. I'll have a link in the description. It's free of cost, and he just does this for free for everyone. And he hasn't done one in more than a year now, more or less, but hopefully this video might encourage him to do this again. Maybe we do a collab or something. That'll be cool. You all know that Figma has a community, right? But most of you don't know that Miro has a community as well. It's called Miro Templates, and it has its own like little website here. And here you can search for templates for a lot of different things, for your design work, for your workflow, for your project work. But apart from that, if you just search for portfolio, which I've done here, you get a bunch of templates made by the community, made by Miro themselves, made by a lot of really cool, professional, very focused people. So you will find less trash here and more like good quality work just put out. For example, one is a basic one by Miro, which is the portfolio template, which is extremely basic. It's good for beginners, but it's really nice if you just want to create a PDF. Everything is done for you. All the data is done for you. Then there's one called Portfolio Starter by Voltage. And Portfolio Starter is all about learning how to build your portfolio, like a starter, get started guide, essentially. Then you even have something called a case study canvas. Then you have results to action workshop. So you have a bunch of things that you can kind of check out from here. But all of these are amazing and 100% free, of course. A tiny resource, but there's so much here, from zero to prototype, career map. There's a bunch of stuff. If apart from just portfolios, you'll find a lot of cool stuff here as well. All right, so the next one are guides by wonderful people at UX Playbook. A lot of these resources used to be paid, but they've kind of made like free versions of these resources. Free UX resources, they're calling it. You have a complete portfolio tips, 101 portfolio tips ebook, which is once again amazing. Personal branding masterclass. So you have an entire free masterclass for personal branding, which personal branding often goes hand in hand with portfolios and CVs and stuff like that. So this will work out for most of you guys as well as a portfolio critique vault. where there are 86 videos, 86 videos of portfolio critiques, all different kinds of portfolios critique, the do's and don'ts, what went wrong, what works, what doesn't, all in one place. A ladder which they've designed specifically for you. So building, executing, supporting, and strengthening. It's kind of like a graph that you can kind of self-evaluate your career, your portfolio, anything. Then you have a UX project kickoff guide. So if you're looking at starting your UX project for like a dummy project, you can always do that here. They have an entire guide on how to get started. They have like, it's kind of like a template plus a guide, which is awesome. Okay, so I found a way for you guys to find the best portfolios from Google, Microsoft, Swiggy, Meta. So we all know of Wall of Portfolios. If you haven't tried out Wall of Portfolios, it's a very vast website that features the best portfolios from all across the globe. Now, Wall of Portfolios has a special feature which they don't display on the homepage as such. So what all you have to do is just say wallofportfolios.in/companies/let's just say Google, and you'll reach the Google page where you'll find all different portfolios from either the previous people who were previously with Google or the present Google employees portfolios all listed out here. So you have both of them, and you have a page dedicated to just case studies by Google, which is of course all the public case studies posted out by Google employees that you can check out, which is insane. Like most of these case studies are generally private property of Google, but some can be made public and they have been listed out here. Any company you want to kind of search for, let's just search for Meta. All we need to do is type in Meta after companies slash and we'll find Meta. That worked. That instantly worked. I wasn't planning for that. Now, here we have the present team as well as alumni, the case studies, and you'll see what other companies these wonderful designers are working for. If there are no case studies, you won't be able to see any case studies. So again, that's a bummer. If I search for... All right, so the next one is by Designlab. And Designlab generally posts stuff, paid stuff, you know, paid courses, paid workshops, stuff like that. But I don't know why this is free or how this is free. It's called How to Present a UX Portfolio During a Job Interview. Now, if you guys have been in a job interview, a lot of companies scrutinize or just open up your portfolio in front of you, in front of the entire team in some cases, and they kind of go through your portfolio and what you've done. So how do you present your work in front of, say, a team or in front of an individual? Maybe it's an online session, a 20-minute long guide. The role of UX portfolio and job application process. How do you apply for jobs and what's the best way of giving the UX portfolios out? It's interview tips. What are the checklists that you must make sure before going into an interview? Very crucial tips. They're calling it hot tips inside this guide as well. And case study formats as well. Also, the importance of asking feedback. How do you ask for feedback on your portfolio when you go for jobs, when you apply for jobs and stuff like that? All right, there's a huge debate. Should we create a website? Should we have a Behance profile? Should we just send out a PDF? Now, this guide by interactiondesign.org showcases how to create the best PDF or presentation-based portfolios. A lot of you guys don't want to create a website. You just want to create a PDF and use that. Of course you can do that, but you can take a lot of this that they've given, all the steps and all the guidances. There are video guides as a part of this guide. There are video lessons. There are tips and tricks. There are lists. There are checklists. There are a bunch of videos that you must watch. These are like explainer videos. They kind of explain each and everything in detail and how you can kind of send out these portfolios, usability and accessibility. How do you visually create that portfolio? Not just the case studies, but also how do you present it in the form of a PDF? Apply it to your portfolio, Behances and stuff. You know, you can do that. Once again, what a gold mine. And this should have been paid. But right now it's completely free. All right, so the next resource is actually on YouTube, available on YouTube, but of course you can check it out on their official website as well. It's a series that Career Foundry has done. And Career Foundry focuses on UX courses and boot camps and stuff like that, a lot of online stuff. Now, this is a success story of Sara Lowry, and she shared a bunch of examples of how she landed a job at BBC, how she applied, what are the portfolio things that she did in her portfolio, in her case studies, etc. Again, a 54-minute long video. Again, of course, you can go ahead and ask by clicking on the Ask button on YouTube. You can ask questions, particular questions, as if you're talking to Sarah here. But she's literally listed out everything you need to know about creating a portfolio, how she did it, and how she landed sort of a dream job. Again, I have created a Google Doc with everything that she has shared, because there are a lot of aspects of what she's gone through, from a beginner to UX designer and everything that she kind of focused on, from learning to the portfolio to the case study, everything. Guys, that is it for today's video. Of course, if you like this video, make sure you click the thumbs up, because that really helps out. I understand what kind of videos you want to keep on watching, and I'll create more just like this. And of course, kudos to everyone who I featured today, from Dann to Sarah. I think they're legends for sharing this work for free. And literally like 6 to 8 hours of stuff I've shared with you. All these can be turned into a course. You can literally kind of ask Gemini or ChatGPT to summarize stuff for you so that you can learn faster. And also, make sure you subscribe to this channel for videos every single week. If you're looking to miss out, if you like missing out on great content just like this, then you're going to miss out. Otherwise, just click on the bell icon as well and say all notifications, just so that you can get all my videos on time. Also, comment down below if you have a portfolio that you want to share with the world. How about we share portfolios which are worthy of sharing down in the comments? I'll see you next time. Until next time, take care. God bless.